Hey there and welcome to this Dutch lesson. My name is Koen and today we are going to talk about the alphabet in Dutch and its pronunciation. This may not seem like the most fun video to watch, but it sure is one of the most important videos to actually learn Dutch. If you want to talk to Dutch people in Dutch and you want Dutch people to talk back to you in Dutch, it's very important to get an understanding of the Dutch pronunciation, since a lot of foreigners struggle with it. So the schedule for this video is as follows. First, we're going to talk about the letters in the Dutch alphabet. And after that, we're going to have a closer look at the letters and name some remarkable things about them. The alphabet consists out of vowels and consonants. For those who don't know what vowels and consonants are, vowels are the letters A, E, O, U, I and Y, which we also call I, and consonants are the other letters in the alphabet. In Dutch, we call a vowel a klinker and a consonant a medeklinker. The alphabet is as follows. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. You've probably heard that the Dutch A sounds like the English A, and the Dutch E sounds like the English E. Keep this in mind, because when I'm referring to a letter in the alphabet in this video, I will call it in Dutch. So the A for acorn is not an A as it would be in English. Acorn means squirrel, by the way. Let's have a closer look to each letter now. The letter A can be pronounced two ways. It can be pronounced short, like A, and it can be pronounced long, like A. So when do we pronounce it short and when do we pronounce it long? This depends on the syllable and how the vowel is written, because it can be written as a short or long vowel. Short vowels and long vowels. In Dutch, we call this korte klinkers and lange klinkers. Have a look at these examples to get a better understanding. Schap, schappen, which means shelf, and the plural form shelves. Schaap and schapen, which means sheep, and the plural form sheep. So the first one, schap, consists out of one single syllable with a short written vowel, so we pronounce it short. Then schappen consists out of two syllables, schap, pun. Here the syllable does end with a consonant and not a vowel, so it's pronounced short. The third one, schaap, consists out of one syllable and is written with a long vowel, so it has to be pronounced the long way. A, schaap. The fourth and last one, schapen, consists out of two syllables, schapen. Here the vowel is written short, but the syllable does not end on the consonant, but on the vowel. So then we pronounce it the long way. Take a second and let it sink in and see why this is very important when learning Dutch. Because I often talk to foreigners who are learning Dutch, and due to these little pronunciation errors, I sometimes don't understand them clearly. Because imagine you'd say, ik vind schapen leuk, but you pronounce it like, Ik vind schappen leuk. Then I think you like shelves. The B or B. For brood, for example, which means bread. Something remarkable for the B is that words ending on a B are often pronounced as P. For example, krap, which is written with a B, but sounds like krap, ending on a P. Krap means crab. C. The letter C can be pronounced two ways. We can pronounce it as an S, and we can pronounce it as a K. For example, club and cell, which means club and cell. So when should I pronounce it as an S or as a K? In most cases, you can apply the following rule. If after the C is an A, E, or A, then the C sounds as an S. If after the C is an A, O, U, L, or R, then the C sounds as a K. The D or D for Diederik, which is most times a boy's name. When the D is on the end of the word, it's often pronounced as a T. For example, goed, which means good. The E or E for rek, re, gewoonte. Vowels are always pronounced long when they are at the end of the syllable. This is an exception for A. When there is only one A at the end of the word, we do pronounce it short. The F or F for film, which means a movie. Then we have the G or G for gretig, which means greedy. The G or G is hard for most foreigners because the sound is pretty hard. The H or H for hond, which means dog. The I or E for kind and historici. Historici is pronounced long since the vowel is on the end of the syllable, as I explained earlier. The J or J for ja, jas and jaar. The K or K for Koen, which is my name. The L or L for leeg, which means empty. The M or M for meneer, which means sir. The N or N for niet, which means not. The O or O for vos and rood, which means fox and rat. The P or P as in pannenkoek, which means pancake. The Q or K for aquarium or quarantaine. This is most time pronounced as K, a K and a W. The R or R for regen, which means rain. Het regent veel in Nederland. It rains a lot in the Netherlands. Regen. S or S for saai, which means boring. T or T for toekomst and politie. Sometimes, not always, when the T is followed by an E, we pronounce it as T, a T and an S. For example, with the word politie. It's not politie, but politie. The U or E for kus or vuur, which means kiss and fire. The V or V for veer, which means feather. The V and the F are sometimes pronounced almost the same, so this can be quite confusing for Dutch learners. The W or W for waarom, which means why. When the W is followed by an R, we pronounce the V as a V. So wrak will be pronounced as wrak, but we still write it with a W. X or X for luxe, which means luxury. The X is pronounced as KS, X. The ei, or Griekse ei, as we call it in the alphabet, for yoghurt and dynamo. So as you can hear, we can pronounce the ei like a J or like an E. And last but not least, the Z, or Z, for zeker, which means sure. That's the alphabet in Dutch. Let it sink in because you did a great job today. This doesn't explain the entire pronunciation for the Dutch language, but you're actually pretty far. In the next video, we are going to talk about vowel combinations and consonant combinations to cover up the whole Dutch pronunciation. So for now, keep practicing and thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to receive more videos like this. Tot de volgende keer!